In 2009, Swedish people were encouraged to take an Ouchie against the bacon fever. In 2008, Glaxo Smith Kline got the approval by the European Union that their Pandemrix was safe and effective, which was based on a trial of 5,000 people. The government paid them about $100 million to inject the whole population. Sweden's Anthony Fauci, who is called Anders Tegnell, was boasting on television that they were the first to inject so many people, and also that they managed to inject so many kids.
There were many other countries who wished they could have vaccinated so many kids that we did, but didn't succeed. Regarding what Ouchie that were to be used, our demand was that it should be approved by the medical authorities in Sweden and in the EU, and it was that kind of Ouchie that was procured.
During a period of 7 months, 5.3 million Swedes were given this experimental treatment. From an official evaluation made afterwards, it was estimated that this effort saved the life of about 100 people. But something really, really bad also happened.
That signal has never been caught before. We have never seen narcolepsy as a side effect reported for Ouchies. So it was not any of the diseases listed as side effects.
So you couldn't predict this. It was not possible to predict this. I was thinking, oh, how horrible, really, what have we done? You feel responsible that you've done such a thing.
It's not only that we injected here, we also advised our children and grandkids. You're thinking, what if something would have happened to them?
The official statistic is that in the order of 150 to 394, mostly children got narcolepsy. Keep in mind that this is the official statistic. The hidden numbers could be in the order of 663 patients. Narcolepsy is a severely debilitating lifelong disease without a cure, where people uncontrollably fall asleep, get sleep paralysis, gain weight, lose control over their muscles, have severe tiredness, hallucinations, and the symptoms are managed with amphetamines and antidepressants. Since people are typically not able to work for the rest of their lives after such a diagnosis, you would assume that a drug company would pay out compensations. If you did, you're wrong. In the contract they wrote with the government, they were given immunity for any possible damages that their vaccine could have caused. The government promised to pay up to $1 million for the one affected by narcolepsy. But to this day, they have typically paid out more in the order of $6,000 per person. In summary, in 2009, the Swedish government spent about $180 million to give a safe and effective Ouchie to the whole population. This saved the life of 100 people, but ruined the life of about 150 to 664, mostly young people. My point with this video is to highlight the concept of unknown unknowns. Every time you try something new, whether it is building a robot, starting a business, or mass medicating a whole population, there are things that will happen that you weren't even aware that they could happen. This is a crucial concept that regular people and politicians do not understand. Most people are aware of known unknowns, which in this context would be how many people the Ouchie will save, and how many of the listed possible side effects the population will experience. But the unknown unknowns are the things you cannot be aware of before you start the experiments. This is why when the authorities tell you that something is safe and effective, and to trust the science, before a mass experiment has been conducted, you know that they are either lying or that they are too inexperienced to understand the concept of unknown unknowns. Thank you guys for watching this video, and don't forget to like, comment and subscribe if you want to see more. Some closing thoughts. It seems like most normal people make the mistake of assuming, since an Ouchie against smallpox, swine flu and the Kung flu are called the same thing, they are equally as safe. The treatment discussed in this video is a great example of why this isn't the case.